Hey, welcome to the Guide of ProMods. Here I will inform you about everything you need to know and do to get the mod running. Things you must know beforehand, how to download, how to install, and give you a few tips as well. To be easier for you, I organized this video in different topics and you can navigate through them in the YouTube video bar. First, if you are not sure what ProMods is, essentially it is a mod for ETS2 that adds much more details to the map. Not only details, but countries, cities and beautiful landscapes. This is a comparison between the original ETS2 map with the DLCs and the ProMods map. Starting off, there are things you must know beforehand if you want to use this map. This map is very sensitive to game versions changes. If you are new to the scene, ETS2 once in a while gets a major update with new features and reworked parts of the map. Unfortunately, every time a new version of the game releases, we will have to wait quite some time for ProMods to be updated and be able to play again in the new version. There is also a workaround about this and I will talk about it later in this video. Being this the downside of using this mod, you will need the map to be updated and download it again. To check the game version you are on, you need to open the game. In the main menu, in one of the corners there will be the version of the game you are running. What is important here, it's the first three numbers. The rest doesn't matter. Using this page, that I will leave in the description below, check if the game version you have matches the ProMods version. You need all this information to match to run ProMods, otherwise you will encounter problems. If you don't see your game version in this page, stop. This means that the map still doesn't have the update for your game version. You need to wait until it gets released. Also, if you check the page when you log in, the ProMods team has an announcement with the progress they have with the updates. If you have the version, good, let's go to the next step. Since you already confirmed there is a ProMods version for your game version, now you need to check if you have the DLCs to run it. You need to have certain map DLCs to be able to run this map, depending on the game version you are playing with. Usually ProMods requires you to own a copy of every ETS2 map DLC. This is required so the team behind the map uses files from DLCs, wasting less time producing things that already exist. You are not sure which DLCs do you have? Don't worry. Go on your Steam library, Games, Euro Truck Simulator 2, scroll down, DLCs. Also check this page again to see what DLCs you need to run the ProMods version you want. Some names are a bit off, but if you click on them, it will open the Steam page and you can check the name better. If you don't have a certain map DLC, you can stop here because the map will not work. In this case, we own every DLC needed, so we proceed to the download phase. If you already confirmed all the info before, let's download. In the first page, you will be prompted to generate the dev file. This is something you need, but you also need to do it correctly. Depending on what you want to do, I recommend you to not mess with any of these settings for now and just click in generate. If this is the first time ever you are installing a mod, I recommend you to watch my guide on how to install mods to learn more about it. For now, just go to my documents, Euro Truck folder, and if you don't see a mod folder, just create one. Notice that it has to be named exactly like this. Go ahead and place the dev file you just downloaded right here. You can close the window. Now we go to the step 2. ProMods has two methods of download. One is free and the other one is paid. The difference between these two versions is the amount of time and work it takes to download ProMods. In game, they are exactly the same map. In the free download method, you need to download the map in parts. We used to download two parts at the same time, but I think that changed. Now you can only download one file at a time and you have to wait a few minutes before you download another file. And of course, you need all the 9 archives. The alternative to this is to use the paid version. Here you will pay 1 euro and you will download one file containing everything you need. There will not be any cooldowns, of course. So if you are going to take this route, go ahead and download the 9 files. Once you have all the files on your computer, here comes the important part. The files come compressed, and you need to decompress them in order for the game to recognize them. 7-Zip is my favorite software to complete this task. So, to decompress all the files, just select them all, right mouse click, 7-Zip and select this option. This way, it will decompress all the files and it will create a folder with all the files we need. Sometimes, and I also don't know why, some file will give us an error when decompressing. Whenever this happens, we need to know which one is it and download the file again. Now we just need to move what is inside the folder that was just created to the mod folder. Now open the game. If you are new to this, to play with ProMods, you need to download a new profile. You cannot use this map in a profile you already have. When creating a profile, you first activate the map mod first. The order of the files to be placed in the load order are important. Usually, if we go back to the download page and go to the fourth step, the load will be there. But for now, you can copy my load order as it is up to date. Fill up all the info and create the profile. And you can play now. If we go down this route, we have to pay 1 euro to download the file. You click in premium download and then full mod in one archive link. It will open this website and here you get to pay 1 euro for the premium download. Once the download finishes, you just need to open the zip and we only need to extract the files inside to the ETS2 mod folder. The paid installation is completely the same as the free installation. If this is the first time you are running this map, you will need to make a new profile. When creating it, the very first thing you should do is load up the map mod. The order of the files will be at the fourth step in the download page. As of now, you can copy this load order and you will be fine. Now get back and fill in all the information about your save and create your profile. Now you can play. ProMods has currently some add-ons you can add to the game for more content to play with. There are currently two official map mods you can use, the Middle East add-on map and the Great Step. There is also the cabin accessories and trails and company pack. To download them, it's pretty much straightforward. I'm going to download them all for the sake of the tutorial, but you can download the ones you are interested in. Once the download is done, open zip of each file and move the files inside zip to the Euro Truck Simulator mod folder. Then in game, all you need to do is load up the add-ons to the load order. Currently, you can use my load order. One thing you can do with this map is install multiple compatible maps. Usually some players use what is called combo map, which basically means they are using a group of maps together. Often ProMods is used as base map for these map combos. Then other maps are added to the load order, along with some fixes, and you expand the map and all the details. If you want to try out a combo map, I strongly advise you to search for one combo guide on YouTube. Usually these combos use a lot of fixes and give you some headaches, if not loaded up correctly. Make sure you use a combo map for the version of the game you have. If this is the first time you are installing ProMods, this section is not for you. But will be in the next update, so feel free to save this video for later help. For this matter, I have my game updated to 148 and my ProMods save and files are on the 147. If you try load up the game, you see that gives us an error. This happens because the files we have here were made to the 147 version, not the 148 that we are in. Adapt this thinking to the future updates as you are probably watching this. So what do we do now? Now we need to go back and download the updated map files again, but you have to bear in mind a few factors. First, you need to know if the map is already updated. If the game just updated, chances are that the new version of the map is not out yet. Although you can still play with the map. If you want to know more about this, go to the next topic of this video. Then you need to know if the game has a new map DLC. If it has, you probably need to buy it. To make sure you need it, please check again the compatibility pro mods page to make sure you need it. Once you validate all the information, you can download the map. Again, if you have doubts, you can go to the download section of this video, because this is all you need. So go ahead, download all the files, or pay 1 euro, extract the files to the mod folder, and you can either save the previous pro mods files for some reason, or replace them with the new ones. The installation is a bit different. Inside the game, go to the pro mods profile, and go to the mod manager. Here, make sure the files are loaded up correctly. Try always check the fourth step of the ProMods download page to see if the load order still is the same. This can be done. While you wait for the map to be updated, the only way to play with it is by downgrading your game. This means you are going to revert the version of your game to the previous stabled version you were playing with before the game updated. For that, you go Steam Library, Euro Truck Simulator 2, right mouse click, betas, and on beta participation you select the version of the game you were using before the game updated to the new one. This way you are going to revert the game to that version and you will be able to run ProMods while you wait for the new ProMods update. Once the new ProMods version comes out, to get back to the normal game version, you need to go back to this Steam menu, and on beta participation you will select none. All the latest game files will be downloaded and the game will be back to normal. Now if you want, you can get the new ProMods files, install them and play the latest version. If you are at this step and have questions, please watch the save update for the new ProMods version section of this video. Well, I think I covered everything you need to know to run this map mod. If you have any questions, please ask them below or visit my Discord where I have a section for people to ask questions and get help. Hope I helped. Have fun.